So the stage is set for a marvellous game of rugby football, a bit of a heavy pitch, but it should be some ball game, Tony.
Yes, we've got a great occasion once again here at Thornwood Park. It's really make or break for both sides, because for Shannon to go into the Christmas recess pointless is unthinkable. They could have beaten Greystones, they should have beaten Cork Constitution. Their backs are to the wall, and they will produce a backs to the wall performance. If Young Munster win today and Greystones do the business in Dublin, they will enjoy the Christmas break as joint leaders. And with Greystones and Gary Owen to come to Tom Clifford Park in the new year, Young Munster will have every chance of being champions. Conditions have decreed that we're likely to have a forward battle, and the team making fewer mistakes might well take the points.
And here come the Shannon team, led by their captain, Michael Galway. Galway knows that Shannon will be up against it today. Young Munster have the stronger scrummaging unit. We're going to see a lot of scrums today. Not so many lineouts as the new laws have shown us. A lot of lineouts under the new laws. And Jerry Clossy, minus the ball, leads out the Young Munster team. The place is absolutely packed here. Fans still coming into the ground. Will it be a repeat of the cup final last year? We'll wait and see. The referee this afternoon is Brian Sterling from the north of Ireland. Tony, it's going to be one heck of a ball game.
Yes, Len, we've got a marvellous occasion here, and it's really make or break for both teams. For Shannon to go into the Christmas recess pointless, I think, is unthinkable, Len. They could have beaten Greystones. They should have beaten Cork Constitution. Their backs are to the wall, and they will produce a backs to the wall performance. If Young Munster win today and Greystones do the business in Dublin, then they will enjoy the Christmas break as joint leaders. With Greystones and Gary Owen to come to Tom Fitzgerald Park in the new year, Young Munster will have every chance of being champions. Conditions have decreed that we're likely to see a forward battle, and the team making the fewer mistakes this afternoon are likely to take the points.
So, Brian Sterling just waiting, the cameraman going down to the Young Munster side to get a few photographs. Young Munster not too keen to line up, but called in now by Jared Clossy. The rain, unfortunately, is coming down. A wet day last Saturday, unfortunately, here in Limerick, after a beautiful day on Friday. Proud anticipating a great game here this afternoon. And Shannon have won the toss. They tossed up, in fact, a sensible gesture there by Brian Sterling. They tossed up underneath the stand here, out of the rain. Michael Galway won the toss, and he is elected to play towards the Ballinenty end of the ground. So Aidan O'Halloran to start for Young Munster. Referee Brian Sterling asked Michael Galway, are Shannon ready? And the ball falls down. Wind is going to be a major factor here this afternoon. And as I said earlier on, the pitch is going to cut up as well. Aidan O'Halloran starts the Insurance Corporation game. A ball goes straight into touch. And Shannon will opt for the scrum back on the halfway line. This is a battle between two brothers in the front row. The Sonny Kiley comes up to put the ball in. Paddy Kenny can't get a swift heel. The scrum has gone over 180, so it'll be reset. And Pat McLaughlin on this side of the scrum. Young Munster get the drive on. The position is gone, and Shannon get a free kick. Knocked on. Scrum to Young Munster.
Lots of anxiety out there, Len, as you can see. The conditions not exactly ideal.
Straight back there, Peter Clossy. But penalty from the referee. A free kick for Crookedin. Sonny Kiley takes the tap. Eddie Halvey. Sidestep from Halvey, and he's still making ground. Fine run from the young Shannon wing forward, Paddy O'Grady. Over the Shannon 22. Drop goal from John Pearce. No, charge down. Peter Meehan it was who charged it down. Kieran Maher. John Pearce couldn't hold it. Knock forward.
Well, the first scoring chance of the game there, set up by young Eddie Halvey. A marvellous run by the young back row forward. But young Munster will be wondering at why those tackles didn't go in. And that was a real chance for John Pearce. Well done to Peter Meehan. He was out very quickly.
Derek Tobin to put into young Munster scrum. Shannon get a little nudge before the ball has gone in. Comfortable young Munster scrum, Aidan O'Halloran. And he gets a good touch. Eddie Halvey has been used in the middle of the line-out by Shannon. But on today's occasion, he's at the back of the line-out. Niall O'Donovan in front of him on the Shannon side. Kieran Maher. Paddy Kenny to throw in. Niall O'Donovan soars. Paddy O'Grady charges. Ray Ryan affects the tackle on... But young Munster have gone over the top, or holding it in fact. You could see referee Sterling signalling there that it was held in the ground. And this is a big chance for John Pearce. And there's only 3 minutes gone in the game, Tony.
All set up by the accurate throwing there of Paddy Kenny. Well taken at the back by Nilo. And tidied up by Shannon. And that all combined to give John Pearce this opportunity now of kicking Shannon into the lead.
So Shannon looking the more alert in the line-out at the start. And now the John Pearce is afforded this chance to put the first points on the board. But just goes to the right of the post. Just seemed to get a wee bit under it, Tony.
And he took a long look at that after the linesman had signalled it wasn't over, because he was quite surprised. I think he thought he'd had it.
Halvey again. This time he's knocked to the ground by Gerrard. Sonny Kiley, John Pearce, Ross O'Donnell, Niall O'Shea, Pat Murray. Shannon looking for a quick ball, but it didn't come out, and it'll be a young Munster scrum.
And I think we may well have spared referee Brian Sterling's blushes there, because that was one of the most blatant forward passes I've seen in a long time, Len. And had Shannon got a score, I think he'd have been a little bit bothered about that.
Young Munster scrum. Declan Edwards holding it at the back. And still holding it. O'Halloran. And gets a safe touch. Paddy Kenny once more checks on the line-out calls. A lot of tap back today, I would say, from the line-out. That one was tap forward from young Munster. But, and they have now taken it back again. Aidan O'Halloran. Little jink inside. But I think Loxley has stolen that one for Shannon. Quick throw in. Gerrards. Gerclossy. Munster still with the ball. Tobin, Pat Murray underneath this one. Well taken by the Shannon full back. But James McNamara charges it down. Billy O'Shea. And eventually pushed into touch by Murray.
Nervous moments for Shannon. Pat Murray, usually the most reliable of fullbacks, doing well to catch it. But James McNamara was up very quickly. That could have been a score for young Munster.
So 12 minutes into the first half, and really it's young Munster's first attack. And you can see on your screens there, the the Shannon 22. Mark Fitzgerald will throw in for Young Munster. This one goes to the middle of the line, but it's back on the Shannon side. Sonny Kiley and Gerrards. But the referee was playing advantage, but I don't think Sonny appreciated that advantage because it was a scrum to Shannon.
Yes, Mr. Sterling, could you kind of blow that whistle a little quicker? Keep it for the Earls off my back.
Well, I think wing forwards like to tell scrum halves earlier on in the game that they're playing. I remember Johnny Barry playing for Shannon. Just loved to tell Tony Ward that he was around. We saw the drive there come on from Young Munster, and that is the first indication of the strength of this Young Munster scrum. We're playing 13 minutes in this first half, and the Young Munster fans sense it, that their team have got a little bit of a moral lift there with that particular scrum, Tony.
Well, the importance of the scrum under these new laws is not quite as big as it was in the past, because we now have far more lineouts than scrummages. But in the few scrummages we've had, there's been a noticeable advantage to Young Munster, and this one could be worth 3 points to them.
So little Aidan O'Halloran lines up this kick. You can see he's just inside the 22. Put the first points on the board of this game. Fine kick from Aidan O'Halloran, but full marks to the Young Munster scrum, and particularly John Packer Fitzgerald and Jared Clausen.
And a huge roar from the Young Munster fans. There's a feeling of unfinished business amongst them, and they really would like to put one over their arch rivals today.
So 15 minutes gone in the ball game, and Young Munster leading Shannon by 3 points to nil, and the Shannon forwards won't like that particular dropout, but the referee is playing advantage. Good drive there from Declan Edwards. Jack Coffey. The Munsters have again. Aidan O'Halloran hanging Gary Owen, but not enough length in it. But Shannon have gone offside. Penalty chance to Young Munster.
That's Ger Clossy there leading as a true captain should. But Shannon will wonder about a couple of those tackles. A marvellous burst from the Young Munster back row forward. And a chance for Young Munster again to get deep into Shannon territory.
But the kick goes over the goal line. So a kick to nothing really. Shannon will be happy with that one. Miscue there from Aidan O'Halloran. John Pearce will restart for Shannon inside his own 22. He goes long. Jeremiah Yamara traps it sensibly. And no frills, puts it into touch and keeps his side on the attack.
A lesson for every aspiring fullback. If you can't stoop to pick it, stop it with your foot.
Jerry's been doing that for the Young Munster team since 1979 and thereabouts. He got his first cup medal when he was 18 years of age, 1980. We'll never forget that particular one. Paddy Kenny throws in to a Shannon line-out. Shannon very, very quickly through on the ball there. A scrappy ball. Young Munster very quickly through there. Scrappy ball.
The tap ball is causing some problems for Shannon. The Young Munster forwards coming through very quickly.
So 17 minutes gone in this first half. Young Munster 3, Shannon 0. Jared Clossy tidied up this one for Young Munster. Tobin. John Fitzgerald was held up. But still Young Munster have it. Tobin. Five burst there. Nolamara, Gerrard. Nolamara very well, Gerrard. Tobin. Peter Clancy can't get over. Aidan O'Halloran. Very Tobin. But the pass was knocked on. Was it a deliberate knock on? Yes, it was. But under the new laws, it's a free kick for a deliberate knock on. Before, it was a penalty. And under the old laws, you'd dispute that, whether that could be a penalty try, Tony.
Yes, you certainly would. And quite honestly, I think referee Brian Sterling's blushes have been saved again, Len, as your Munster almost got in for a try. And I did think that in that movement, there was the ball was knocked slightly forward. But the referee hasn't given it, and your Munster still have a chance to score.
Well, you have the advantage of watching that on your television screens. John Fitzgerald. Ray Ryan goes for the line. Is he in? He must be. Oh, referee won't give it.
That had to be a try. A lot nearer than I am, but that seemed to me as if it had to be a try.
Well, a gap just opened up there. It was an excellent ploy from Young Munster. Obviously, they've worked on this in training. A gap just opened there from Ray Ryan, and he thought all his Christmases had come together. He went for the line, but just as he did so, Shannon's team converged on him, or a few Shannon, the players, converged on him. And Brian Sterling says, no, you didn't get it down, son. Derek Tobin puts it in. Declan Edwards holds the ball, goes for the line. Ball bursts out of his hands like a bar of soap. Pat Murray goes across his goal line, and the Shannon fullback gets a fine touch. Middle of the line ball to Ray Ryan, Aidan O'Halloran, little rubber, Billy O'Shea. Oh! Almost took Pat Murray. Pat Murray concedes the 5-meter scrum. Well, Dan Gallagher nearly had his head removed there, Tony.
Yeah, it's a case of Shannon getting the calls on again, because Billy O'Shea was doing what he considered the only option he had. And Sonny Kiley, in the meantime, has rejoined the fray, but this must be a marvellous opportunity for Young Munster. All the options open to them.
A chance to drop goal here. Aidan O'Halloran is shaping for it. And will the pack go? Brosnan goes on the dummy run. Declan Edwards holding the ball, and the scrum goes down. I reckon they'll take another scrum. Captain Gerard Clancy has a quick word with his brother Peter, and Peter says, no doubt about it, we'll go in for this scrum. Down they go again. Second surge. Down goes the scrum again. No prizes for guessing what they'll do. They'll score on the 3 points. They're going for a 7-pointer here.
Something of a gamble, and at the second time of offering, they've decided to kick the penalty.
So decided to take 3 points. I wonder, was that the right option? Safety first policy anyway, because you could see the drive of that Young Munster pack, though, Tony. The front rows, as we predicted, Peter Clancy and John Packer Fitzgerald definitely have the upper hand on Pat McLaughlin and Mick Fitzgerald. Aidan O'Halloran right in front of the post, puts it between them. We're playing 29 minutes in this first half, and Young Munster ahead by 6 points to nil.
And most of those 29 minutes have been played in the Shannon half, and really the 6 points difference is no more than Young Munster have deserved.
Second row. So Paddy Kenny to throw in. Mick Galway at the back with Kieran Maher for Shannon. Galway gets it, but Gerrards is on top of him, and Gerard Clancy. Gerrards looking for support. Ball seemed to go forward. Shannon have it. John Pearce to Pat Murray in front of his own post. Francis Brosnan was almost on to him, but again the Shannon fullback gets the ball away to touch.
Again, coolness and composure under pressure by Pat Murray. That wasn't the kind of pass that he would have liked to have got under his own post with big Brazzy ranging down on him, but he did well.
Young Munster still in the attack. 32 minutes gone in this first half. They lead Shannon by 6 points to nil. As Mark Fitzgerald throws, Declan Edwards tidies up. Aidan O'Halloran for the drop goal. Hanging and goes between the posts. Fine drop goal from the Young Munster out half.
He specialises in them, Len. He did it for several years with Thomond. In fact, he dropped 3 goals in a Munster Junior Cup final a couple of seasons back against Gary Owen. And in that territory, he's lethal.
Right on the halfway line, Paddy Kenny throws. Pat McLaughlin taps back to Eddie Halvey. Eddie Halvey is playing with guts and thunder. Loxley goes on a charge. Niall O'Donovan with him, Paddy Kenny. Shannon know they have to take this ball on to Young Munster. But unfortunately, right in front of us here, Gerrards and Pat McLaughlin got involved. Right in front of the touch judge, the stand and the referee. So both referee and touch judge, Noel Sexton and Brian Sterling, call the two players together. In fact, the three men are about the same height. So I'm sure Brian Sterling says, if it happens again, which you could see, in fact, the two players shook hands there just as they parted. I'm sure they were both relieved that they weren't sent for the early show. But the warning went out, clear. If you do it again, you're off.
And in fairness, Loxley was more sinned against than sinner on that occasion. A little bit of pulling and dragging, eventually deteriorating into something slightly more serious. And a chance perhaps for John Pearce as we come near half-time to pull Shannon back in the game.
Well, I feel, Tony, if Shannon are to make any effort in this game, John Pearce would have to put over this very difficult kick. Curling for the post, but it just goes to the outside of them. Very good strike from the Shannon out half, but just didn't curl in at the last minute for him. So with 38 minutes gone in this first half, Young Munster lead Shannon by 9 points to nil. Aidan O'Halloran to restart for Young Munster. The ball just bounced just before the touchline. Be Paddy Kenny to throw in. Anthony Foley in front of Eddie Halvey there. Two young lads now in the Shannon back row. And Paddy Kenny decides to go short. He was knocked forward, no advantage to Young Munster. It'll be a Young Munster scrum. Derek Tobin puts it in. Scrum goes down. Two Fitzgeralds fighting it out on the far side. And I wouldn't say there'd be any brotherly love there today. Great pals, of course, off the pitch. But they have a job to do on the pitch. Declan Edwards holds the ball. Derek Tobin says he'll take it. Aidan O'Halloran, and Aidan O'Halloran puts it into touch. Coming up to half time now, Young Munster will be very happy with their first half performance. Solid 9 points in the bank. They've come here in a high after beating Dungannon last week in Greenfields. Shannon have yet to get a score, yet to get a win in the Insurance Corporation League. Tobin, O'Halloran, Shannon offside. A penalty to Young Munster.
And Shannon's problem is their lack of primary possession. The Young Munster pack are winning the ball with great ease, setting up the platform for their halfbacks and keeping Shannon under pressure.
An injury to, it looks like one of the forwards there. Young Munster forwards as Aidan O'Halloran puts the ball into touch. We're just on half time here at Thomond Park. Young Munster leading Shannon by 9 points to nil. And the line out is right on the halfway line. Unfortunately for us here in the stand, as often happens when the wind blows here at Thomond Park, all the play over on the far side of the field. So the crowd on the popular side getting full value for their £4. Mark Fitzgerald goes long. John Packer Fitzgerald tidies up. Ball had been knocked on. And referee Brian Stirling just played 1 minute of injury time and blows for half time.
So at half time in the Insurance Corporation League match, Young Munster are leading Shannon by 9 points to nil. We'll rejoin you after the break for second half highlights.
Times in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow.
Lean on me when you're not strong. I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on. For it won't be long till you're gonna need somebody to lean on. You just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. You just might have a problem that I'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. Call me if you need a friend. Call me.
Bank of Ireland.
Call me.
Helping to make things happen. Back in the early 1800s, Thomas Carling embarked on an historic journey. It took him from his homeland to the snow-capped peaks of Canada. There, amidst the ice and the snow and the pure air, he discovered a very special brewing technique known as cold filtering. It made his lager as cool as the landscape that inspired him. Carling Black Label Lager, cold filtered.
Neville's Shoes, Sports and Leathers, Limerick's number one footwear and sportswear shop, O'Connell Street. One of the biggest selection of men's and ladies' sports shoes in Limerick. Men's and ladies' Echo shoes, biggest selection in Limerick. Rugby and soccer boots, running shoes, track suits, and rain jackets. Adidas, Umbro, all leading brands. Men's and ladies' leather and suede jackets now in stock. Why not pay a visit to Neville's new suede and leather department for the best selection in ladies' and gents' suede and leather jackets in Limerick. Neville's, O'Connell Street, Limerick.
Peter Meehan takes this one, but Pat McLaughlin comes round, but the referee says it has been knocked forward. No advantage to Shannon, so it'll be a Shannon scrum. A Young Munster scrum. So you can see the brothers Fitzgerald here at this side of the scrum, in against each other. Declan Edwards holds again at the back of the Young Munster scrum. Now it's to O'Halloran. O'Halloran goes outside and decides not to kick for touch. Kicks long using the wind. Pat Murray puts the ball into touch. But a net gain for Young Munster of some 40 metres. Good tactics there from the Young Munster out half.
And they will feel that's all they have to do in the second half. Keep Shannon pinned into their own half. Keep it as tight as they can. And they've won it.
So line out once more on the far side of the field. Mark Fitzgerald will throw in. Back once more, Young Munster doing very well in the line out. But Shannon have pinched it. Anthony Foley gets his first run. Sonny Kiley. Shannon opening up, Pat Murray in the line. Niall O'Shea with his brother Billy outside him. Billy takes on Joe McNamara. Good covering tackle from Derek Tobin. Ross O'Donnell in there for the ball. But that's the tactic that Shannon will have to use.
Yes, and it all started by a marvellous piece of skullduggery and robbery by Loxley, because Ray Ryan in fact won that line out. But the man who pinched it was Loxley and smuggled it out. And Shannon threw it about, and they're going to have to do that, as you say, Len, in the second half, if they're going to come from that 9 points down.
Mike Galway and Kieran Maher. Nick Fitzgerald, Sonny Kiley to John Pearce. I wonder would it have been better passing the ball on that occasion, Tony.
4-3 down the left-hand side. I think they should have spotted, but it's still a great opportunity.
So 11 minutes into this second half, Young Munster still leading Shannon by 9-0. But Shannon have definitely lifted their game in this second half. And they're on the attack there, you can see them. Just about 10 metres short of the Young Munster line. And Mark Fitzgerald getting ready to throw in for Young Munster. Well tidied up there by Young Munster. Cries of offside, and the referee says yes. Shannon player, I think it was Paddy Kenny in fact, went round offside. So it'll be a kick to Young Munster. You wouldn't call this afternoon's game romantic football, but the conditions have dictated that it's going to be a tight game.
Surprisingly enough, the pitch has held up very, very well indeed.
Pat Murray on the counter-attack. Puts up a Gary Owen. Joe McNamara, good take from the Young Munster full-back. Billy O'Shea. James McNamara of him. O'Shea, fine sidestep from O'Shea. But the ball has gone forward. Referee playing advantage. Gerrards with the ball. Young Munster have a good advantage from referee Brian Sterling. A fine kick by Tobin. Pat Murray recovers, but can't get the much distance on his kick. And the ball, in fact, went into touch and goal. And a big chance here for Young Munster. Scrum 5. Well, an excellent kick there, Tony, from Derek Tobin. Saw that Pat Murray was up in the line and put the ball straight down the field.
Yes. Sensible piece of scrum half play and a marvellous opportunity for Young Munster now.
Will Shannon get on the drive? But the scrum has gone round, it'll be reset.
Aidan O'Holland just having a word with his scrum half. If you like, I'll pop over a drop goal for you, he says.
Declan Edwards has the ball. Young Munster tried to drive it, and the scrum has gone round again. 14 minutes into the second half, Young Munster leading Shannon by 9-0. Big chance here for the boys in the back of the monument to put more points on the board. And once more, the scrum goes down. Derry Tobin puts in. Declan Edwards holds. Penalty to Young Munster. And will they take the 3 points or another scrum? A little debate here. I think they take the penalty, and Peter Clossy seems to be in some trouble. Aidan O'Halloran right in front of the post. And puts it between them. 12 points to nil. Fine kick by the almost out half.
Add something of a body blow to Shannon, who had opened the second half very well. And it has to be said that those 3 points are really against the run of the play, because Shannon have dominated the second half up to now. And that's really disappointing from their point of view.
Taken by Anthony Foley there for Shannon. But because they didn't play the ball quickly, it'll be a Young Munster scrum. Derry Tobin to put in. Aidan O'Halloran down the short side. But Ivan Duggan put his foot in touch. Paddy Kenny again to throw for Shannon. Derry Tobin tidies up very well as the Munster scrum half. And Gerard Clossy plays scrum half there. Billy O'Shea. Now will he have a run? James McNamara chips over his head and the ball goes into touch.
Billy has looked very exciting when the ball has come his way. From a Shannon point of view, that just hasn't happened often enough this afternoon.
Mark Fitzgerald to throw in, checks with Derry Tobin what the call is. Peter Clossy gets a fine round of applause from the crowd here as he goes in under us here in the stand. Penalty chance to Shannon, and they'll probably go for the points. We're 20 minutes in the second half. Still a long way to go.
Yes, Pat Murray asked referee Sterling what's left in this game, ref. You've 20 minutes, chaps. And that decided it. Penalty right slap in front of the post. And an opportunity for Shannon to narrow the gap to 9 points.
So 20 minutes gone in this second half. Young Munster leading Shannon by 12 points to nil. John Pearce. And John Pearce finally gets the rein. And Shannon have broken their duck. 12-3 now, Young Munster lead. Shannon desperately looking for points on the board. Young Munster, this will drive out. Sonny Kiley looks to have this ball. John Pearce. Ross O'Donnell, Aidan O'Halloran takes him, but it's still Shannon's ball, and another penalty for Shannon.
In a very scorable position, and need I remind you that should John Pearce kick this, then a converted try would win the game for Shannon.
...28 minutes gone in this second half. Can Shannon do a Lazarus? Because that is exactly what it would be. Trailing 12 points to 3. John Pearce. And John Pearce again puts it between the sticks. 12 points to 6. Young Munster lead. 28 minutes gone in this second half. A grandstand finish again, Tony.
And a finish we're going to have. And I have no doubt that very live in Young Munster's fans' memories will be that finish at the Cup last year when Shannon pinched it right at the death. And they're still very much in this ball game.
And Aidan O'Halloran commits the cardinal error, as John Pearce did in the first half. Ball goes straight into touch. Foley took a quick throw, but the referee says, no, come back here. You can, in fact, take a quick line-out. That's one of the options if the ball goes straight into touch. And Anthony Foley, very quick to that possibility, but the referee had blown the whistle, so it will be a scrum. Sonny Kiley to John Pearce. John Pearce to Pat Murray. Billy O'Shea off the right foot. James McNamara gets O'Shea this time. Ball back in the Shannon side. Loxley goes on a charge. Crowd really razzed up now. Sonny Kiley. John Pearce. Skip move. O'Shea. Foley up in the line. And a fine run from Dan Gallagher, but just got into touch by Jerry McNamara. And Shannon have really picked up their game.
And suddenly the Young Munster nerves look very jangled indeed. Ivan Duggan there on the far side of the pitch almost made a hash of scrambling that one into touch. And that would have presented a try to Shannon. But they're still in a very good scoring opportunity.
So the adrenaline pumping in Shannon's veins now. It looked as if the game was going Young Munster's way. But Shannon, they fought many a good fight here before at Thomond Park, have lifted their game. Now can Young Munster respond? Peter Clossy is off the field. Derek Tobin puts in. Young Munster desperately trying to calm things down. Aidan O'Halloran. But he gets more height, and in fact that is definitely one for Ballinanti. Into the garden to Ballinanti, but doesn't get much ground. Wind is gusting now across the pitch. Just 10 minutes to go in this game. Just 6 points between the two sides. Shannon's hooker, Paddy Kenny, throws in. Paddy O'Grady got that one for Shannon. Shannon now winning line-out ball and driving forward. Referee checking about the Munster backs or the offside. Shannon still have it. And they still maul. Kiley to Pearce. Pearce. O'Shea, Pearce. Pat Murray. Little O'Shea outside him. O'Shea gets man and ball together. Great tackling from James McNamara.
And vintage Shannon player from the pack. They almost succeeded in getting over on the left-hand corner. Switched the point of attack. A couple of beautiful dummies by John Pearce there, and Billy O'Shea almost in.
9 minutes to go. Still just 6 points between the sides. It looked as if this game was going to go Young Munster's way, and quietly so. That has all been changed in the past few minutes. Mark Fitzgerald to throw in. Ray Ryan taps down to Derek Tobin. Derek Tobin gets it into touch but doesn't gain any ground. Paddy Kenny's throw. Does Shannon win this line out? I reckon they're going to run it. Can see the forward sucking it in there. Fine take from Halvey. Kiley. Anthony Foley. With Pat McLaughlin with him. Kiley again. Pearce. Ross O'Donnell. Loop. John Pearce has the ball in front of the Young Munster post. And there you saw the new law. Shannon players shake their heads in disbelief, but that is the harshness of that new law. If you don't play it, it's a scrum to the opposition.
Yes, an illustration there of use it or lose it at its worst, if you like, from a Shannon point of view, because that was a great scoring chance.
Declan Edwards holds it in the back of the Shannon scrum. He'd love to hold it there for the next 7 minutes. Young Munster drive out. Billy O'Shea, James McNamara, it's a bit of soccer here at the moment. Dan Gallagher can't take it, but a penalty chance for Shannon.
Yes, Gerard's there ahead of his young Munster player who kicked the ball, never tried to retreat. Has Shannon opened it again, Len?
Fine drive for Michael Galway. Shannon tails are up, Sonny Kiley, John Pearce. Interception there from Francis Bosnan, purposely done, and it's a free kick. It's all Shannon at the moment. We've just 6 minutes to go.
And one wonders if that, if the punishment fits the crime there, Len, because that was a crucial interception. And really, just a free kick for it seems harsh justice from a Shannon point of view.
Nick Fitzgerald over the ball, takes the tap. Shannon going to a huddle. Drive it forward. Will the ball come out? Yes, it does now. Sonny Kiley on the blind side, John Pearce. Overhead pass to Dan Gallagher, but the ball goes into touch.
Well, this game may have been fairly lackluster in patches up to now, but it's more than compensating in this final few minutes.
5 minutes to go. Young Munster 12, Shannon 6. Young Munster desperately defending. Shannon picked up their game by almost 100% in the second half. Eddie Halvey goes high. Sonny Kiley gets man and ball together. Young Munster come forward and get the penalty.
Crucial tackle there by Gerard and Sonny Kiley. Gives young Munster now an opportunity of lifting the siege, of calming themselves down, of getting themselves organised for these last few minutes.
It was a fine take there by Eddie Halvey, fine tap down, but unfortunately the block wasn't there. Sonny Kiley got ball and man together and he just couldn't do anything with it, so young Munster come away with the ball. Four minutes to go. Still the 6 points between the sides. Young Munster 12, Shannon 6. Shannon desperately seeking the ball. It will be a Young Munster throw, Mark Fitzgerald to throw in. Checks with Derek Tobin. Ball goes long. Declan Edwards, a fine take by him. But it was a crooked in. Referee asked Shannon, what they have, and they have the scrum. Another chance for Shannon. The backs will have to move it. An injury to a young Munster player. Hold play up for a bit. But down they go now, Sonny Kiley to put in. Scrum is wheeled around by young Munster, and purposely so. Quick tap, well taken there, Anthony Foley. Sonny Kiley, Ross O'Donnell, Niall O'Shea, Pat Murray, Billy O'Shea. The cover is too good there though. And there was a sea of black and amber jerseys there as Pat Murray and Billy O'Shea converged on the young Munster line.
Most unfortunate that the two of them should hit the same point at the same time, and the frustration in the Shannon backs when that ball didn't come back and the penalty was awarded to young Munster was very obvious. They know the time is running out, and that was crucial.
Quick throw in from Shannon, but of course they can't do it because it was a penalty. Right in front of us here, the crowd rising to these two teams. Down through the years, they've been great rivals. always produced a stirring contest, and they left it for the last 20 minutes to raise the hackles here at Thurman Park. Ray Ryan gets the tap, and his colleague Peter Meehan tidies up. John Fitzgerald goes into Kieran Maher. On the blind side, Tobin, Billy O'Shea underneath it. Billy O'Shea, as slippery as Tony says is a kneel. Kieran Maher with him. Shannon Desmond looking for the ball to move it out. But Kylie goes on the blind side. Tobin charges down. Billy O'Shea. A penalty for Young Munster. And that could be the final nail in Shannon's coffin, Tony.
Yes.
O'Halloran makes no mistake with that one, Tony.
But it's a mixture of celebration and relief, because Young Munster have lived very dangerously indeed for the last 15 minutes or so. It's been a marvellous comeback by Shannon, but surely that now sounds the death knell.
James McNamara pumps it back down to Billy O'Shea. Billy O'Shea to Pat Murray, dummies to him. John Pearce, Ross O'Donton, back to Stan Gallagher. Shannon's still running it. With Sean Munster coming away with the ball. Pat Murray. Eddie Halvey, who's had a fine game today. Pat Murray knocked forward. Francis Bosnan to Mark Fitzgerald. Referee was playing advantage. No advantage to Young Munster. Their scrum. And we're 1 minute into injury time. John Packer Fitzgerald. Ask referee Brian Sterling, how long to go, ref? Young Munster leading Shannon by 15 points to 6. Look as if they have the points in the bag before a recess in this insurance corporation. Derek Tobin. Billy O'Shea underneath that one. Pat Murray. Niall O'Shea. Ross O'Donnell. Niall O'Shea recovers. Sonny Kiley. Ball goes into touch. And the referee blows full time. And the Munster fans have thrown their arms into the air. Marvellous victory for them, Tony.
Yes, it compensates to some degree for losing the cup final.
And so here at Thurman Park, Young Munster have taken the points. We're going to take a short break now, but rejoin us in a moment or two for the verdict.
Times in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. But if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow.
Lean on me when you're not strong. I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on. For it won't be long till you're gonna need somebody to lean on. You just call on me, brother. Just might have a problem that I'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. Call me if you need a friend. Call me.
Bank of Ireland.
Call me.
Helping to make things happen. Back in the early 1800s, Thomas Carling embarked on an historic journey. It took him from his homeland to the snow-capped peaks of Canada. There, amidst the ice and the snow and the pure air, he discovered a very special brewing technique known as cold filtering. It made his lager as cool as the landscape that inspired him. Carling Black Label Lager, cold filtered.
Neville's Shoes, Sports and Leathers, Limerick's number one footwear and sportswear shop, O'Connell Street. One of the biggest selection of men's and ladies' sports shoes in Limerick. Men's and ladies' Echo shoes, biggest selection in Limerick. Rugby and soccer boots, running shoes, track suits, and rain jackets. Adidas, Umbro, all leading brands. Men's and ladies' leather and suede jackets now in stock. Why not pay a visit to Neville's new suede and leather department for the best selection in ladies' and gents' suede and leather jackets in Limerick. Neville's, O'Connell Street, Limerick.
We have a few delighted Young Munster fans here, but the last few minutes were very nervous indeed, Tom, weren't they?
Very nervous indeed. I thought we played well throughout the whole game, though. Our forwards were magnificent and our tackling and defensive work all throughout the game. I thought it was second to none. We, just as the president of Shannon said, it was sweet revenge, but long time overdue, a long time coming. And today I think we proved that we're capable of being in the first division of the All-Ireland League.
I'm sure nobody for an instant thought today in those last few minutes about the cup final.
Well, I certainly thought about it, and I said certainly they can have the cup now. But on the, today's game, Peter Clossy was a big loss in the second half to us, you know. So it's a sweet victory, and I'd wish Shannon every success in the next match. I wouldn't like to see him going down in fairness. Keep it in Limerick.
Who was your idea of man of the match today?
Man of the match, it's hard to distinguish any individual. But I suppose, you know, if you put me to the pin of my collar, I'd have to say that Declan Edwards was there or thereabout. He among the rest, the other 14, that's all I could say. And I would like to emphasise what Tommy said there. I wish Shannon every success for the remainder of the season, because we need the Limerick teams, we need one another, we need to go out there and show the rest of the country what Limerick rugby is all about.
Greystones have to come to Tom Clifford Park, so too have Gary Owen. So can I ask you fellas, who's going to win this Insurance Corporation League?
Shannon Munster!
Thank you, Tate.
I think a majority verdict there from these fans in favour of Young Munster. Let's see what Lendonade has.
Well, after a game...
Portadown 37, Armagh 3. Queen's University...
...percent record to Dayton Division 1 at home advantage. Cork Constitution were well set in their bid for another All-Ireland title. First, though, they had to take on second-placed Young Munster...